I always loved to draw. So from my early childhood, I remember that. And drawing to me meant everything, basically. So I drew houses, but I also drew landscapes, and I was very interested in that. And the struggle went on for quite some time, so I wasn't sure whether I would become an artist or an architect. So part of my education went into art, and then back to architecture, and again into art, and ultimately into architecture again, and that's how it came about. Recently, we just completed this with two of my colleagues and certainly my students at Texas Tech University, which is, we call the Sustainable Cabin, which is a design-build project which we started out at an elective courses of mine, which is called a product design elective. And we just completed this particular design-build project, and it's now on its permanent site in Kroll, Texas. What's really significant on this is that we are looking at the basic building materials. For a start, we used the existing mobile home platform. It was from a double wide, which was 53 feet long by 13 feet wide. So instead of putting this all in a landfill, we went and chopped the trailer to our dimensions and basically added the materials which are sustainable, for example, also bamboo flooring at the inside, natural pine as a cladding for the walls and ceiling, and cotton insulation, which is basically a recycled blue denim cotton, which is turned into thermal insulation. So those components from a material base are sustainable. And then in addition, we went further and we basically set this cabin off the electrical grid, and therefore now have solar panels who are having the only means of power. And the other part is basically harvesting the rainwater and having a compost toilet on site. So it basically is a self-sufficient dwelling. And for us, is we can provide a learning experience which the student later on can't really repeat, because they will have to generate the profit. Furthermore, the student's going to work on projects where they are in actual offices, so that hands-on approach of touching the 2x4, they will never have that, because architecture draw buildings, they don't make the actual buildings. But with that hands-on approach, what they have this one experience that, I remember how this was when I worked on that. This is actually not that easy, it was quite tough. And it gives a better understanding for the craftsman who is there dealing it for a career to come. And I think that's a very important aspect we're providing here. So again, an educational service learning started out for me always as an important part, how to reach out to those people who maybe don't have as much. And one service learning project we did is with Rosa Sheets Hernandez from Education. We basically did a project together called The Bookworm, which is located in the Salvation Army here downtown Lubbock. And what it does is we provided shelves and play area for children who come there and play and actually purchase a book or being read to. And the book would actually be affordable price. So the concept idea is to give them a space for young children how to learn how to read. I love to teach, so, and I think it's not like this is stopping or ending at some point. It's very difficult to explain, but the interaction with young people and the idea of education, or when you see that a student can actually blossom or find something out about themselves, the discipline and progress students make, basically is a big reward for the work I do here at Texas Tech.